Variance measures how spread out the values are from the mean in a data set. A small variance means values are close to the mean, and the square root of the variance is called the standard deviation. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use the var function to compute the variance and the SD function to compute the standard deviation in R. So I'll look at a couple different data sets. I'll look at a random sample. Let's call this random sample V. Use the sample function. I want values from 1 to 100, and I want 10 of them. So if we look at V, there's 10 values. So what's the variance here? It's as simple as doing var on V. And if we want the standard deviation, we just do SD on V. So we have a standard deviation of 28.96. Now, we could get a data set. Let's do another sample. So sample 100. So I'm going to use this vector that's returned by sample. But let's put an NA value. So we have a missing value in our data set. Now, both variance and standard deviation will return NA if there's a missing data point. To get around that, we can remove it. So like many other functions in R, we can do na.rm equals true, and this will remove the missing data points before computing the variance. And the same with SD. SD v na.rm equals true, and it computes the standard deviation. Now R comes with a number of built-in data sets. I'm going to use one called trees. So trees contains some measurements of these cherry trees, 31 of them, and in these 31 observations, there's the girth, the height, and the volume of the tree. So let's compute the variance of the height. So we can just do var. We give it the trees data set. We want the height column. So the variance in the trees is 40.6. And the standard deviation is 6.37. So if we look at the data set here, so you see here's the girth, the height, and the volume of the trees. So we have the list. So we're looking at the height, the second column. So we've determined the variance of the height of the trees to be 40.6 and the standard deviation to be 6.37. And that's all there is to it. So that concludes this video on how to compute variance and standard deviation in R.